Manual restraint is required for most medical procedures in the companion parrot. Before handling the bird, obtain a thorough history to identify and avoid potential problems. Carefully observe the bird at a distance for signs of illness. If the patient is severely debilitated or dyspneic, consider supplemental heat and/or oxygen before handling. Discuss with owners the inherent risk of handling the critically ill bird. Parrot handling also carries potential risk for medical staff, since even friendly birds may bite if they feel threatened. Evaluate the exam room for any potential safety issues. Make sure all doors and windows are secure. Pull down window blinds to cover glass. Minimize potential hiding places and ensure electrical cords are not exposed. Reduce activity around the bird, and if the cage must be moved, do so carefully to avoid jostling the patient. Gather all equipment that may be needed, including a towel or paper towel of appropriate size. Inspect cloth for fraying, as threads can catch on feet or other body parts. Approach the parrot calmly and quietly. Keep the towel out of sight until you are ready to begin. Some birds handled roughly in the past will react as soon as they see the towel. Slowly introduce your hand with or without a towel covering it and encourage the bird to step up. Never remove a bird from the owner's arm or shoulder. Gently hold the second and third digits of the foot and slowly move the bird into your chest, being sure to keep the parrot's beak beneath your chin. Bring a towel towards the bird and drape the cloth over the bird's back and or head. For small flighted birds or for large parrots that won't come out of their enclosure, slowly remove any items that might hinder capture or pose a risk to the patient. Then gently yet firmly use a towel to secure the bird in a corner or against the cage wall. Restrain the head with one hand and support the torso and the wings with the other hand. With the palm of your hand resting on the bird's back, encircle the bird's neck with your thumb and forefinger without constricting the neck. To ensure that you have good control, you can place the knuckle of your thumb in the bird's intermandibular space. With this hold, you should have full control of the bird's head without a tight grip. Be careful not to put excessive pressure on the bare facial patch of macaws or African gray parrots, since the skin will bruise. This is not a practice builder. Small birds can be restrained by using your palm to support the bird's back, thumb and last two digits to cradle the wings, and the second and third digits to restrain the head. Use your second and third digit to control the bird's neck by placing its head towards your fingertips. Birds breathe by moving the sternum in and out, so be careful not to inhibit the movement, as this will rapidly lead to respiratory compromise. Minimize handling time so the bird does not overheat or become overly distressed, and monitor the bird closely for any changes in strength, breathing, or attitude. Immediately after handling, some birds are tachypneic and agitated while others become quiet and subdued. Most birds return to normal activity within 2 to 3 minutes unless there is underlying debilitation or if the restraint period was prolonged.